Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have another really great Cricut Infusible Ink tutorial. This time we are using the Cricut Infusible Ink pens with your Explore Air 2. And guys, we are making this really cute tote bag.
All right, guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and I have imported a mandala design that I really like, and I think it's really nice and springy, being that we're coming up on spring. So I thought, hey, why not? And I'm going to put this on a tote bag. So it's a relatively squarish design, meaning I can make it proportionate in both width and height, and it still looks really good. And what I've done is, and of course, you have a video on using the slice tool, but I was able to use the slice tool to separate out the background into four colors. But especially if you're a beginner, I would really suggest just sticking with one or two colors to begin with, just so that way there's not a whole lot of confusion. But I was able to split mine up, and then let me show you. Let me unattach it. You can choose your colors by up here in the top left-hand side. You will make sure that you have pen selected. Of course, if you're doing this on a foil quill or something like that, then you will come down here. But I'm using the infusible ink pens made by Cricut. So I'm gonna use pen. And then of course I can select the color that I want. Now, once I get done selecting the colors, and of course I change them all to pen, you can select them all and choose attach. Now, for a normal cut design, remember that attach changes it all to one color. I was afraid that would happen with the pens, but it doesn't. So that's really cool. So if you come over to make it, you'll see that it is all listed on one sheet. And that's what we need. And I do want to go ahead and mirror it because this is going to be put ink face down, kind of like you do heat transfer vinyl. So it'll be inked down against the material that you're pressing on. So mirroring it is good. Let's hit continue. And of course, it's going to go ahead and connect to my Explore Air 2. Now, you can also do this with the maker. I just happen to have my Explore Air 2 already down from a previous project, but there's no, you can even do this on a Cricut Joy. You can get the infusible ink markers for the Cricut Joy as well. Now, under base material, I do want to check out, let's see, I'm going to type in paper. Let's see, I actually want just like a regular paper, oh, there we go. I just completely overlooked it. We're just gonna select copy paper. I'm actually using sublimation paper because I just happen to have some, but guys, you can totally use copy paper for this as well, okay? Now it'll go ahead and tell me to go ahead and load my infusible ink pen. And I just wanna say, remember guys, in Cricut Design Space, you're used to having a workflow over here, and you don't have that with the infusible ink pens because they're all on one mat, but it'll tell you. So we're gonna go ahead and load the pink, and then we will do the orange, the yellow, the green, and the blue. All right, so let's go ahead and walk over there, and we are going to go ahead and load the cutting mat with the sublimation paper on top, okay?
All right, guys, so what I have here, I'm using my blue light grip mat because I am using paper. And I have this was actually a 13 by 19 sheet that I cut down to fit on my cutting mat to be 12 by 12. So we're gonna go ahead and load it. And the first pen that I want to use is my pink, my neon pink. And let's talk about loading and unloading pens. This little guy here, this very first carriage holder that you have, will lock and unlock to accommodate your pens. So I've removed the cap and I'm going to insert it down and give it a little push. Okay, it will lock in, and then I can actually lock this part of it here. So make sure that you push it in far enough that it doesn't, there's like some brackets in there, some little brackets that will clamp down on it, and then make sure you lock the actual carriage itself as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the Cricut button, but you will notice, because of course I'm gonna do this on high speed for you guys, I don't wanna bore you, but you'll notice that I'm going to start working my way, and what I'm going to do, because it told me, I'm gonna do orange, yellow, green, and blue, all right? So I'm gonna do those, and that probably has to do with the order that they are on the mat, but I'm gonna line them up here so that they're ready, and you'll see me switching those out throughout the process. Now I've unlocked it. I'm going to give it a pull, and you'll notice that my light is flashing again here. That's how I know that it's ready to change. So I'm going to go ahead and put my orange marker in and repeat the process and hit this again. All right, guys, so I deliberately told you guys to watch your colors and it'll tell you what's next. And I got ahead of myself. I did these all wrong. But luckily for my design, it still works really, really well. So I'm obviously still gonna use it. So let's unload it from here and let's close this guy back up. We can get him out of the way. That will give me more room to work. And then actually what I'm going to do is I am by hand going to go ahead and color in my ladybug. And that is what is so great about these infusible ink markers is you can really get a good mix of what your machine does and what you can do by hand, because you can use them either way. Now, if you missed our introduction to infusible ink markers, or rather, I believe this just says sublimation markers, I will link that video for you so that you can check it out. But basically, this is a special type of ink that you can use, and it will fuse with polyester fabrics. So I have a cute polyester tote bag, and I'm going to, like I said, color this ladybug in, and then we will press it. It's a heat activated ink that when you press it, when you heat it up at 400 degrees, it will turn into a gas to fuse with the fabric. So that's kind of where the infusible ink name comes in. Now, infusible ink markers are a great way to start testing the waters for sublimation, because there's a lot of things that you can do with the markers that will mirror what you can get before you're ready to jump in and buy a sublimation printer. So it still allows you to use your fabulous cutting machine, because of course we all love to use our Cricuts, but it just kind of starts to get you out of your comfort zone of, you know, sticking with vinyl or cardstock and your typical materials that you can cut. Now, Cricut actually makes a line of infusible ink markers that are intended specifically for coloring by hand. So if you have artistic ability and that's something that you are interested in, then make sure you check those out. Now, there are other markers that are available that are actual sublimation markers. And of course, you do have some ability to use those. You can actually also mix and match those. All right, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and clean up my station, get everything out of the way, and set it up for heat pressing this design. Now, like I said, I have this cute polyester tote bag. Now, I actually got this at Michael's. I just happened to catch that it was polyester, so it should work really, really well, 100% polyester. And then because it's white, I am going to slide a sheet of paper inside, a sheet of butcher paper. That is so that my ink does not transfer all the way through to the other side of the tote bag. And I want to try to make sure it is as flat as possible in the cutting or in the pressing area. So it's okay that I have the gusseted bottom down here. I just want to try to smooth those out so that they don't interfere with my area. Now I am going to go ahead and spray a little bit of adhesive spray on here. This is a repositionable adhesive spray. You don't have to spray a whole lot, but just enough to tack it on there. Let's center this to our bag. And I'm going to cover it with another sheet of butcher paper. Now I am using my Cricut Easy Press, and I'm going to fast forward through this part, but it's going to be 400 degrees for about 60 seconds. And guys, because I'm using a 9x9 Easy Press, you'll see me press multiple times to make sure that I get it all covered. Just know that if you're using a regular heat press, then you don't have to do that. You can just press it one time. Now, the infusible ink markers, as well as sublimation, they do not rely on a lot of pressure, but it does need to be consistent pressure to have consistent colors. So I am going to press and I'm going to lift it up to move it, but I'm just not applying a whole lot of pressure, which feels weird if you're used to using heat transfer vinyl, but it's just one way that Sublimation, aka Infusible Ink, works with your pressing. Now, the reason that you use the blowout paper is because, remember when I said the ink will turn into a gas to be able to absorb into the substrate? What that means is that sometimes you can also have ink try to escape and go places that it doesn't belong, such as your heat press or underneath your design. So it's always good to have this blowout paper. It's going to catch the ink that tries to escape. That's the best way I know how to put it. And also be very careful if you are moving an easy press around. If your design happens to shift underneath, then you will have something called ghosting that can also happen when you're removing your design. And that is part of the reason that it's really good to use like the adhesive spray or heat safe tape to tack down your design to make sure that it doesn't shift. So I'm gonna carefully remove my butcher paper and even more carefully peel back my design. Ooh guys, look how cute it is. So I did have a little bit of fading down here at the bottom, if you can see. That is, I obviously just did not get it lined up real well with my Easy Press. But guys, I'm still very, very happy with the way that the bag turned out. Here, let me show you, because I don't stress too much about the bottom, because whenever it is gusseted out, you most likely will not see the bottom anyway. So really, really cute design. I really like it a lot. And like I said, it's one of probably my new favorite things to do because there's just so much versatility. So of course we drew the majority of our design. We did color in by hand with the ladybug, but guys, you can also just buy a black marker and do your entire outline and then color it in that way also. And don't forget, I said that there were those other infusible ink and sublimation markers to check out. So if you like this process and you're looking into getting more into sublimation or infusible ink, then these are definitely something you want to add to your crafting arsenal. Because one of the great things about using infusible ink and sublimation is that this is completely fused to the fabric. There's no fading, there's no peeling, you can't even feel it whenever you touch it. So really, really neat and definitely something worth trying. So guys, how did you feel about our tote bag project? Now, of course, I really love it. I really love the way it turned out. I really think that these Cricut infusible ink markers are a lot more versatile than most people realize, because I feel like I got a full color design out of markers, and that's pretty rare in my opinion. Now, of course, don't forget about those single line designs, because those are really, really awesome, and they are the perfect complementary design to using these types of pens. So, if you have any questions about the process that we used today or using infusible ink markers, definitely make sure you leave those below, because I love to hear from you guys. And make sure you subscribe to the channel, because that helps us to keep the channel going and to keep bringing you these videos in the future. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, guys, but thanks again for stopping by. I really do appreciate it, and we'll see you again next time.